Good morning. How's everyone doing?
Good.
Good to see you all. Well, today we have a very important lesson. We're going to talk about God's love. Now, God's love, sometimes people just don't understand it. They think that you can measure God's love. You know, Scripture tells us from the 23rd Psalm that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. My cup overfloweth, or my cup runneth over. So I have a measuring cup. So can we measure God's love according to a measuring cup? Can we put all of God's love in here and actually measure it?
No.
No, it won't work, will it? Just won't work. Even though the psalm says that our cup runneth over and that we know that God loves us. You know, Scripture also tells us that God's love is higher than all the heavens. Therefore, I have a ruler. Maybe we can measure His love all the way up to heaven.
No.
No, you don't think that'll work either? You don't think that'll work? Okay, then let's try something else. Scripture tells us that God's love lasts from everlasting to everlasting. Therefore, I have a very nice watch here, and I'm going to time God's love. And we'll see how long everlasting is. How long do you think I'll stand here? No, I won't, because eventually I'll die. Because I won't be eating, and I won't be drinking. It won't be any more than 3 days. So therefore, can we really measure God's love from everlasting to everlasting? By using a man-made watch?
No.
That's not what Scripture is telling us, is it? What are we hearing today? How do we know that God loves us? What did we hear in the gospel lesson today? For God so loved the
world that He gave His one and only Son, whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Very good. You know, there aren't many kids in the world that know that, by the way. But you all know it. Thanks be to Jesus. So what is Jesus telling us here? How do we measure God's love? How do we know that God loves us? He died on the cross for us. We don't have to put His love into a measuring cup. We don't have to measure it with a ruler. We can't time it with a watch. We believe it in faith. We know that in faith we know that Jesus has done this. And therefore our faith clings to this. Our clinging holds on to Jesus. We never let go of Jesus because we know that He loves us. Do you know what the 17th verse says? That God didn't send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through Him. Through Him. See, these are great words of gospel. And that's how we as Christians, that's really how we measure God's love according to the gospel. Because we know that Jesus did come and that He was lifted up. Just as the snake was lifted up in the desert, Jesus was lifted up, put up on a cross. And what did Jesus do here at the cross? What did He do for all of you? He died and washed away all your sins. He took your sins to the cross, and therefore by Him shedding His blood, He washed away all your sins. This is love. You can't put this into a measuring cup. You can't measure it with a ruler, and you can't time it with a watch. It's actually visible for us. Every time we see the cross, we know that this is a symbol of love for us, and it tells us that God loves us. And we know that God loves us because when we hear of love in the Bible, that means that there's been a sacrifice. And when we hear that God loves us, it tells us God has sacrificed Himself. God has sacrificed Himself so that you and I can live forever and ever and ever. We don't need a watch. All we need is the Word, and His Word tells us that it's the truth. So today you're going to hear why it's so important for us to hear the gospel and to believe the gospel and to hold on to this cross, to hold on to Jesus and never ever let go. So with that, let's fold our hands and close our eyes and let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank You for coming to be our Savior. Lord, Your love tells us that we cannot measure it, that we cannot use any kind of human device, O Lord, to measure Your love. But Lord, we know that Your love is true, for we know that You did sacrifice Yourself and that You did allow Yourself to be lifted up, that You freely gave Yourself so that in Your love we could be saved. Thank You, Lord Jesus, for this great work that You have done. And all the children said,